told her that, you know, what are the signs? How can you say that Islam is right? I was like, you know, if I were to ask you that, how do you prove that you are my mother? How can I believe you? If you are really angry, you will throw me out of, whether you believe or not, I don't care for you, I don't need, I can get another son, get out of this place. You will tell me this. But if you are patient enough, if you have compassion, you will tell, you will show me the photo. See, this is your father, mother, we got married, and this is your birth certificate, I am your mother's name. You will give me the proof. These are the signs, you will tell me, based on these signs, for me to believe that you are my mother. Now, these signs are more than enough for me. But even if I am arrogant enough and he asks, no mother, I will not believe you as my mother, unless I see that I should understand that when I am birth, I am taking birth under you, you know, from you. And she will say, bloody hell, you cannot be there with that consciousness to see me, to perceive that you are my child, you know. So she'll say, whether if you want to believe, you believe, these are the signs. But if you don't believe, get out. I will have another baby, no problem. So similarly, Allah time and again says in Quran, whether if you want to believe, believe it. You're not doing favor on me by coming to, you know, namaz, by doing all this. You're not doing favor to me. So then, you know, school exams, my college exams. Suddenly declared that today will be your results. Well, I'm doing, going through all this. And I was struggling with all this, so I never gave so much time to my studies. But alhamdulillah, I scored well. When I went to college, you know, results were delayed. I was so scared and shocked that if I fail, my career is gone. You know, I will take one more year and the people will not respect me. My mother will beat me. I will lose job, etc., etc. And I just thought that only because I'll fail in my diploma, my, you know, entire personality is shaking, that if I fail, I'll be gone case. But though I have another chance to prove myself and get better, I am scared if I fail, you know, I will not be successful in this world. Just imagine if I were to fail in this world by not worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what will happen to me on the day of judgment? Because you have lost. You cannot, once you fail in this world, there is no other chance for you to get past in the hereafter. So, you know, this made me strong, that these are the Allah's signs for men of understanding to believe. You know, they just don't, the deaf, dumb and blind, they don't believe, they don't come to the path. And I was just thinking, you know, it's like deaf means basically when I don't want to hear, I just, you know, when I was telling about Islam to my mother, she just used to go away. And she used to tell, don't sit with him, he'll brainwash. She used to tell my sister, don't sit with, you know, this guy, he will brainwash you and he will also get you on this. So I used to say, yeah, this is what deaf means. Because though I want to say, though she has a capability of hearing, she does not want to hear because she knows it's truth and she does not want to get into these complexities. So this is what deaf means. I thought, yes, this Quran is so live, subhanAllah. Mind blind, though they see every day and night, but yet they are not believing in Allah's signs. It's true, every day I see day and night. For 18 years, I never thought that this day cannot be done by accident. But now when Quran is saying that they are blind, it makes sense because my complete priority was earning the money, making my career, you know, bringing up myself like that. So I never thought of this. So it's basically for those who are conscious. So I was like, yes, my conscience was lost in earning and worldly matters.